In this video, I'm going to discuss why, after 2.5 decades of being an architect, I started to recommend the TOGAF certification. And I now recommend with enthusiasm the TOGAF certification for cloud architects, solutions architects, enterprise architects, AI architects, and a whole host of other architect careers. A little bit about me. I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers, and I've held every kind of IT architecture role you can imagine for the last 25 years. Network architect, security architect, business architect, enterprise architect, you name it. I've held all these roles and I've loved every last one of them. I've also spent more than 2 decades helping people just like you get your first tech job, get promoted in tech, land their first architecture job, and it's something I've loved to do. Now, for a long time, people asked me about TOGAF, and I said, it's not necessary. But I've changed my position on it about 1.5 years ago, and here's the reason why. I've always felt strongly that you should have 2 to 3 really good professional or expert certifications, and I did the same myself. I held the CISSP and the CCIE, 2 hard certifications that were there for building my brand. Now, in recent worlds, I now added the TOGAF, and here's the reason why. Most of the architecture certifications out there in today's world, things like the AWS Solutions Architect Professional Exam, the Azure Solutions Architect Expert Exam, the Google Professional Cloud Architect Exam, they have very little to do with architecture. They teach junior level systems administration. Here's the name of a service, and here's how to configure that. Now, sadly, that has absolutely nothing to do with what we do with architecture, which is designing systems that improve our clients' business performance. So what's happening is employers are starting to see that those cloud architecture certifications and many others, they don't prepare people for certification. So you need something to help build your brand and get you that interview. It's your competency that gets you hired, but it's your certifications that can help build you an interview along with the quality of your resume. And TOGAF is a architecture certification. It sits out there as a well-known, globally recognized standard. The Open Group and its architecture practices, for the most part, are known by everyone who matters. If there's a major organization in technology, they are a member of the Open Group. So you're signaling that, plus you're signaling that you have an architecture certification. So for the purpose of having 2 to 3 good certifications, TOGAF is one of them, and that's one of the reasons I recommend it. Now, the next reason I recommend it is focus. A lot of people want to become architects, and I've trained them, and they work at Apple and Amazon and Cisco and Google and Microsoft and Accenture, Deloitte, KPMG, Capgemini, PricewaterhouseCoopers, JPMorgan Chase Bank, Barclays Bank, LeaseWeb, Kelly, and I've trained architects that work at all of these companies. And the challenge becomes when people want to enter the architect world is, what do they learn? So in an architecture world, we're designing systems to improve our clients' business performance. That means evaluating their business. That means evaluating their business processes. That means re-architecting their business processes. That means leading teams to evaluate the organization's technology. That means leading teams to design the organization's technology. That means responding to RFIs, RFPs, RFQs, the creation of statements of work, the creation of architecture repositories and architecture documents. And when someone sees the scope of what's in TOGAF, the type of documents we create and the type of things we need to do, it makes them think twice about learning Python or learning DevOps or learning SysOps or learning engineering skills. And it's very hard for new architects to focus on the right things because they just don't know where to begin. And the focus of TOGAF, which doesn't teach you how to design an architecture, but says, start with the business vision, then go to evaluate the organization's business processes, then go to re-architect that organization's business processes with their key leadership, then evaluate their technology platform, then et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It keeps people that want to be architects focused on the right skills to further enhance their skill development so they actually get the right skills. Why do I say this? Well, I've trained architects now for decades. And when most people come to me, they actually learn all the wrong skills for their architecture career. They learn all these engineering skills, and whether it be cloud engineering or DevOps or network engineering, but they never learn the architecture skills. So TOGAF keeps people from focusing on the skills for someone else's job. Now, the last reason is actually client success. So while there's no part of TOGAF that teaches architecture, it does provide a methodology that says step 1, start with the business vision. Step two, work on the business processes. Step three, evaluate the organization's, you know, technology. And why do I like that? Well, that kind of checklist, one, two, three, improves outcomes. And we've got lots of examples in business where it works. And it works in complex situations. For example, in open heart surgery, they actually use a process, step one, step two, step three. An airplane pilot, when he or she gets into a plane, they use a checklist to check all the systems on the plane to make sure they don't find problems mid-flight. So that checklist approach of TOGAF is really great. So in summary, why did I change my position in TOGAF after more than two decades? Right now, TOGAF is one of the few certifications actually out there that actually has anything to do with architecture. The Cisco Certified Design Expert is another example of an architecture certification, where certifications like the AWS Solutions Architect Professional or the Azure Solutions Architect Expert or the Google Professional Cloud Architect, they really don't have any architecture. They're more about systems administration, the name of a service, and how to configure it. It keeps us focused on the right skills, and of course, it keeps us focused on the eye of the ball, which is delivering good business outcomes for our clients, as opposed to just designing technology systems. If you desire a career in enterprise architecture, cloud architecture, AI architecture, security architecture, please check out the description of this video. We have free webinars to help you become an architect, free ebooks to help you become an architect, and even free guides to help you win the interview on your next architect interview. So I encourage you to go to the description of this video, take advantage of some of these free resources. If you've liked this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I wish you a wonderful architecture career. Take care.